everybody, and welcome to Children's Church. This morning I have a very special gift here for us all. I don't know about you, but I love getting presents. Now this present is extra special because it's all the things that God gives people who love him. So I don't think we can wait any longer. Let's open it. What is this? A heart. This is God's gift of love. It's the love that he gives us and the comfort that he provides for us. What else? What is this? Oh, a Bible. Now, the Bible is also a really special gift from God because it gives us all of his promises and shows us the way to live our life. What else is in here? A family photo. Now, that's just my family, but this is reminding us that when we love God and we know God, we're part of a much bigger family. This means that we have other people who love and care for us, and we have people to pray for us when we need it. Now there's one more thing in here. Torches. That's strange. This one works. This one doesn't work. Now, this can remind us of a very special gift that God gives us, the gift of the Holy Spirit. Now, I'm sure if we opened this to see why it wasn't working, we'd find that it has no batteries inside it. Batteries are like the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gives us the power to live our lives the way God wants us to. When we don't know God and we don't have the Holy Spirit, we don't have those batteries that show us how we should live our lives. Did you know that God sent the gift of his Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost, which is today? We can see more about that in Acts chapter 2. But first, let's remind ourselves of what's happened just before this. So Jesus has ascended or gone up into heaven. But before he did this, he told his disciples to wait for a special gift in Jerusalem. I want you to think about a time where you had to wait for a gift. You knew you were getting it, but you had to wait. It takes a lot of patience waiting for a gift. And this is exactly what the disciples had to do. They waited 10 days for the special gift of the Holy Spirit. John 14 verse 26 helps us understand what the Holy Spirit is. It says, "But the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all the things and remind you of everything I have said." Another word for a counselor is a teacher. So the Holy Spirit comes to help us and teaches us about living a life that God would be happy with. For example, when we learn new verses, the Holy Spirit helps us to remember them when we need them. Since that time, so many years ago, each person who knows and loves the Lord Jesus has received the gift of the Holy Spirit in their hearts. We might not see flames on top of each other's heads or hear loud wind noises like it says in the Bible. That you can find in Acts chapter 2 verse 2 to 4. It says, "Suddenly a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit." But we do receive the power of the Holy Spirit to help us in our lives. and help us to live lives that God would be pleased with. If you aren't sure whether you have God in your heart or the Holy Spirit guiding you, ask God to come and live in your heart so that you can be like the flashlight with batteries. Let's close our eyes and pray together. Dear Lord, you know each one of our hearts. If there are those this morning that want you to come into their hearts, we ask, Lord, that you would do so. Help us to allow your Holy Spirit to give us the power to do the things we know will please you. Let us see your power in our lives this week as we trust you each day. In Jesus' name we pray these things. Amen.